To use batch reporting in LMS Test Lab, first go to Tools Add-ins and select Batch Reporting. No extra license is required to run batch reporting. After you've turned it on, it will appear as a new worksheet. You can select some data for plotting. They can come from multiple runs or from a single run, whatever you desire. And then once you go to batch reporting, you can activate this data. You can grab a format that you've made previously. In this case, we have a PowerPoint file. And then we're going to add some columns here. And by adding these columns, we'll be able to sort the data in a way that we want to plot it. So there I've added a test lab run name. I'm also going to add some individual block information like the point ID, point direction. I'll also select a section value. And now we have some data. We can group this data. For example, here I have a group where I'm looking at run 2, Z directions of the right mount body for orders 2, 4, and 6. I can look through the different groups. They look pretty logical. Each group will be one page on the resulting PowerPoint. I then select the data, put it over here, make sure I have print to all here, and now I'll hit print. I have 24 items in my list. I'm printing 3 at a time, so my resulting PowerPoint should have exactly 8 pages. It's going through. It's running PowerPoint in the background. And then when it's done, I should have a PowerPoint file on my desktop. It says it's done. Minimize test lab here. Open up desktop PowerPoint, and indeed I have an 8-page report, and each page has 3 pages of data. Now I can go in and maybe I want to sort the data a little bit differently. For example, I might sort by section value, then I'll sort by direction, then I'll sort by run, maybe by section value again. And now I can see maybe I want to group this data just a tad differently. I'd like to plot all the second order data. And I'm going to remove all the curves from here. And now I'm going to plot it for run 1 and run 2. So the data will be overlaid. And because I have a group size of 8, this can step through 3 times. And I'll be able to plot and make a 3-page report with overlay of data for all my second order data, and then my next group is my fourth order, my next group is my sixth order. If I go ahead and hit print here, I'll print to the same file. Now instead of having 8 pages, I should have 3 pages. So I've used the sorting and grouping to control exactly how I want the data to come out. It's done. We'll open up the PowerPoint file, and there you can see we have 3 pages. First page is all second order, fourth order, then sixth order on the third page. And that is how batch reporting works.